accept Christ, you'll never see them again. So by fire, by force, they must know that I'm speaking about a God who is a living God, who dwells in me, who dwells in you. He's the same God, the creator of the heavens and the earth. He's a strong God. He's a strong God. He's a strong God. Friends, don't joke aloud with the salvation. There is nothing greater than you. Because actually, you don't exist. I was telling people, and I'm tired of just calling me Dr. David. I want you to call me Jesus David. Because as I'm living, my name does not appear first, but Jesus appears first. So the David is inside Jesus. So you call me Jesus David. So when Jesus David comes, David comes in Jesus. Because David is embedded in Jesus. So when Jesus comes, when David comes in Jesus' name, when David comes in Jesus' name, no man can stand. Fire! The Bible says, that my God is a consuming fire. But the consuming fire dwells in me. So it's simplicity. Joy, you are consuming fire. In simplicity. Somewhere you were consuming fire.
Somewhere
I want to see a generation that is not going just to be persecuted. I want somebody to claim me because I have made miracles. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
You must do something great. These people, they claim that we have been preaching Christ, and your Christ is not seen. Let your Christ be seen. The Bible says, blessed are those who are persecuted for my name's sake, for theirs is the kingdom of God. But before they persecute me, I must position myself. I must be a consuming fire. Oh God, people, you are great. You are great. Not because of who you are, but because of what He has made you to be. Not because you chose yourself. You were chosen by God to be a great man, to be a great woman.
Amen.
So where is the problem? Where is the problem? Where is your faith? Polish Galatian, who has bewitched you? I'm preaching to myself. Oh, foolish David. Who has bewitched you to a level that they have blinded your eyes? You can't see the great God in you. Beyond your measure, you operate in the name of Jesus. Beyond your boundaries, you must operate in the name of Jesus. God is not limited by time, because He created the time. God is not limited by finances. He's the God of silver and gold. God is not limited by wealth, because He's the one who created it, and He gives it to whom He desires. It does not take any method for Him to change. You are great, my sister. You are great, my brother. Kawasa, you are greater than you think you are. So when we stand to preach, Jesus is preaching. Yesu yababulira.
Amen.
That's why sometimes
yes, so
when I'm speaking these words,
when banjo get every gambo, you know,
people do not understand.
I want to tell you together,
but I want the people to know that Jesus is speaking.
Yes, you get that.
I no longer live. But Christ lives in me. I am a new creation. The old David, you knew God. Is no longer in existence. As I'm speaking, I died with Christ. I resurrected with Christ. And now I'm seated with Him on the right hand of the Father. Every the other minute, I come from heaven because I'm a heaven citizen. I come from heaven to come and execute the work of my Father. The work of my Father. The work of my Father. I'm making up my mind. I don't know about you. Before I leave this earthly tent, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Not preaching about me. But as I'm preaching, take it yourself.
Yes.
Before I leave this earthly tent, surely, somebody must know.
Why not?
It's a God who exists. I will do it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So that the name of the Lord will be known. If Elijah
called
the fire,
he bite
the matawa.
Njaita.
Amina.
I will do what it takes for people to know that the God I'm speaking about is a living God.
Yes.
And it's not very far.
Yes.
But it's in
yes.
me.
Yes. Wow.
I'm tired of postponing things of God. Postponed healing. Postponed deliverance. Postponed salvation. No. When God says, let there be, so there was. And God said, let there be light. So it was there. Today, in the name of Jesus, I pray that as we live here, we know that we have the fullness of Christ. So when